Hello everyone! Today I'm going to show you how to optimize your computer's FPS, input lag, network efficiency, OBS, Sony Vegas, and much more, all for free. Please watch until the end of the video for more details. This will be a brief tutorial on how to run a free and open source batch file, also known as Home Control. Keep in mind that this tutorial is for Windows machines only. So, before we proceed, there's a few words that I need to state. If you're from the Intel Edits video, please note that the Hone Discord tweak folder is outdated and will cause issues. Hone Control is the successor and contains the same optimizations and much more. With that being said, we can't guarantee an FPS boost from applying our optimizations. Every system is different. Secondly, everything is used at your own risk. We are not liable if you damage your system in any way. If you don't know what a tweak is, please don't use it. You can make a ticket on our Discord and ask for more assistance. And lastly, even though we have an automatic backup feature, some users have issues with it. So we highly recommend making a restore point. To make a restore point, go in your search bar, type control, open in your control panel, go in System and Security, click on Allow Remote Access, System Protection. Here, you'll see your C drive. If protection is off, click on Configure and turn it on. We also recommend you use a max usage of about 5%. Click on Apply, OK, and click Create. You can name your restore point whatever you want, but we recommend using the current date. Alright, to start off, there's two ways to download the Home Control panel. The first and main one is through our Discord, in which you'll meet our friendly staff and get updated on everything Home related before anyone else. And there you'll see the download channel. The second way is by clicking on the first link in the description down below. This link will lead to the official GitHub page of Home Control. You can download it right off the releases section. After downloading Home Control, please note that you may need to run the file as administrator. Once open, you'll see a disclaimer. Read it carefully before typing I agree and press enter. Now you should see the main page. Please keep in mind that depending on the time you're watching this, the menu could look different. To proceed to the optimization section, press 1. Once opened, the process to optimize your computer is quite simple. To turn on an optimization, enter the corresponding number and then press enter. To turn off, enter that same number again and then press enter. The first 9 tweaks are safe, and we heavily recommend them, even for the average user. However, only apply the power plan optimization if your laptop is plugged in. Do not apply it if your laptop is on battery. Tweak number 10 to 15 are for NVIDIA GPU owners only. To know if you have an NVIDIA GPU, do this. Right-click your Windows logo, go in Device Manager, Display Adapters, and if you see something named NVIDIA, congratulations, you have an NVIDIA graphics card. To access page 2, press N, then Enter. The bloat tweaks are all about removing telemetry, adware, and overall bloat that runs in the background of your computer. This is especially beneficial on lower-end machines. The network tweaks are all about improving your internet connection and latency. Only apply the Optimize NIC optimization if you're on an Ethernet connection and not Wi-Fi. The GPU and CPU tweaks will optimize the best settings for your GPU and CPU respectively. To know if you have a Intel or AMD GPU, you can go back in your device manager again in display adapters, and if you see Intel graphics or something named AMD, you have one. The miscellaneous section features several additional tweaks, such as Cleaner, which will clean adware and temporary files. We also have Game Booster, which will set your GPU and CPU to high performance on selected games, and a soft restart, which will restart several processes on your computer. This concludes the optimization section. To head back to the main menu, press B and then Enter. To proceed to the Games section, press 2. The Games section will change your in-game settings for the best possible performance. Currently, we only support the Minecraft settings, but in the future there will be more support for other games. If you don't have Minecraft installed, please feel free to skip this part of the video. To proceed with Minecraft-specific optimizations, press 1. Then, pick the Minecraft versions that you play on the most. This concludes the Game Settings section. Now, we'll go over the Media section. Please note that in the current version, 2.52, we do not support AMD graphics cards. But that will be coming soon. To proceed to the Media section, press 3. In here, you'll see 4 sections: OBS, FFmpeg, Blur, and Vegas. Once opened, the process is quite simple. To enable an option, enter the corresponding number, and then press Enter. The OBS section allows you to install OBS and automatically apply its best settings for both recording and streaming. The FFmpeg section allows you to adjust videos for lower file size, better quality, or to fix lag issues with Sony Vegas. The Blur section allows you to pick the best motion blur settings for both Minecraft and first-person shooters. The Vegas section allows you to pick the best project and render settings for Vegas. Please keep in mind that we only support Vegas version 17 and 18, but a future update will be coming soon. In this example, I'll be upscaling this video to 4K. Press 1. Drag your video in, press Enter. And voila, it's already done. As you can see, the video has been upscaled to 4K. To install Vegas, press 12 on your keyboard and then Enter. You will notice that we don't provide an installer, but we do provide the link to buy a real copy of Sony Vegas. We also provide a link for a free alternative called DaVinci Resolve. For example, if you want to render an Apex Legends gameplay, do as follows. Or actually, I'll just let a render expert Monk explain it.
So, I will go to 3 for media, then I will go to 2 for recording. Now, my settings are the optimal settings, but I can't do it right now because I do have OBS open. But you want to hit 2, and then I record in 240 FPS. But not all computers can do this, especially low-end computers. So I would see which FPS you can really record in. Otherwise, if you know your computer is very good, then you can just type in 240. So after doing that, I then blur my clips. So blur settings, and then 8 for FPS games, because Apex is an FPS game. And hit 8, and then this does depend on what you recorded your Apex in. See, the higher you record your Apex in, the better output you will get. So if you record in 60 to 120 FPS, then you want to press 1, otherwise press 2. So I record in 240 FPS, so I'm going to press 2. and then you want to drag your video file into here and it should blow it for you. So the last step is to upscale the video. So this is how I get my 4K videos. So you want to hit 4 and then you end up to go to 4K, 8K. It takes a long time and it doesn't do much. So I do recommend doing 4K. It's very quick and should be fast on most systems. So you want to drag your newly blurred file into here and then it should be done. So let me roll a clip of what I got.
This concludes the media section. You may have noticed that the sections privacy and aesthetics have been grayed out. This is due to these sections not being done at the time of this video being recorded. You can join the Hone Discord server for future updates of these sections being added. Finally, there's the more page, which shows additional information and allows you to take a manual backup if needed. This is the credits section, which shows all the lovely people who've contributed to our program. There's also the advanced section. Keep in mind that there are very experimental, sensitive tweaks that we normally don't recommend most people to run, so they come with their own disclaimers. This concludes the advanced section. To head back to the main menu, press B. If you'd like to support our work, feel free to leave a review on our Trustpilot or click the second link in the description down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.